Okay, so now I'm going to teach about a very good evening. Sorry for the everything which has happened. Right, so we'll start with the bishop's score, and today I'm going to exclusively tell you about the bishop's score. So what is bishop's score? Is something which you have to because it was asked in the JIPMER 2020 as well as AIIMS 2020. I believe that we should be knowing about the bishop's score. So in the bishop's score, bishop's score includes all except. So this was a question which was asked in the AIIMS 2020 June session. Dilatation of the cervix, length of the cervix, position of the cervix, type of a maternal pelvis. So bishop's score includes all except. So what is the most appropriate answer in this option? So the most appropriate answer in this option is the bishop's score includes dilatation of cervix. It also includes the length of the cervix. It also includes the position of the cervix, but it does not include the type of maternal pelvis. So the answer here is D, that is the type of maternal pelvis. Right. So now what do we mean by the bishop's score? So in the bishop's score, I want you to remember the mnemonic of speed. To remember the bishop's score, I want you to remember the mnemonic of speed. Yeah, the spelling of speed is weird here, but yes, this is the mnemonic which I want you to remember. So S tells about the station, C consistency of the cervix, P position of the cervix, E effacement, D is dilatation. So these are the components of the cervix. So we have the station, consistency, position, effacement and dilatation of the cervix, right? So these are the main main included in the scoring system. Now in the among these, station -3 is very high up, so it will have a 0 score. -2, 1 score. -1 to -0 is the score 2, and as soon as the plus comes, +1 and +2 gives a score of 3. So we mainly have the scoring system as 0, 1, 2 and 3. Coming to the dilatation, in the dilatation, if it is closed, we get a 0 score. If it is 1 to 2, we get a score of 1. If it is 3 to 4, we get a score of 2. And if it is 3, we get a score of 5 to 6, it is a score of 3. Now dilatation ka ulta is the effacement. Actually now we don't consider effacement. What we consider now is called as the length of the cervix. What we consider now is the length of the cervix. We no more consider the dilatation effacement. Effacement is outdated. In modified bishop's score, it is mainly the length of the cervix which we take into consideration. Okay. So if you observe here, length and dilatation will be ulta. Closed, 0. If length is 0, we get a score of 3. 1 to 2 centimeter dilatation, score of 1. Whereas 1 to 2 centimeter length, we get a score of 2. 3 to 4, score 2 here. 3 to 4, score 1 here. So it is completely ulta. Can you observe here? It's completely ulta. So remember that way, it is completely ulta. It will be easy for you to remember. So dilatation closed will give you 0. Dilatation of 1 to 2 centimeters will give you score 1. Dilatation of 3 to 4 centimeters will give you a score of 2. Dilatation of 5 centimeters will give you a score of 3. Whereas the length more than 4, it gives you a score of 0. 3 to 4 will give you a score of 1. 1 to 2 will give you a score of 2. And 0 will give you a score of 3. Okay. Similarly, in consistency, firm consistency will give us 0. Medium consistency will give you a score of 1. Soft consistency will give you a score of 2. Position also we have similarly, posterior, midline and anterior. So based on that you have the scoring system which goes up to 13. So here they mainly asked us regarding the what are all the parameters. So how do you remember the parameters? Remember the parameters by mnemonic of speed. That is station, consistency, position, effacement, and dilatation. Okay? So remember by this mnemonic of the speed. So as the B looks like 8, a bishop score of 8 or greater is considered as to be favorable. A bishop score of 8 or more is considered as favorable. And you have more chance of vaginal delivery with induction. Right? A bishop score of 6 or less is considered unfavorable. So you should use cervical ripening agents when the score is 6. You should use cervical ripening agents when the score is 6. What is the drug of choice for the cervical ripening? The drug of choice for cervical ripening is dinoprostan. That is PGE2. We also call it as Cerviprime gel. So cervical ripening is mainly by the dinoprostan or the Cerviprime gel or the PGE2. The only side effect with dinoprostan is it causes uterine hyperstimulation and it can make the woman land up in the fetal distress and cause meconium stain like. Another very important drug which we use for induction of labor and induction is misoprostol. Nowadays we are also using mifepristone for induction of labor. And what is the only prostaglandin which should not be used, for induction of labor? So PGF2 alpha is not used for induction of labor, right? Most important component of Bishop score is position, dilatation, station, effacement. So all these are definitely the parameters of Bishop score. Among these, which is the most important component of the Bishop score? Position, dilatation, station, and effacement. So the most important component of Bishop score is dilatation. So this is a single liner which you have to remember. The most important component of the Bishop score is the dilatation. All of the following are used for induction of labor except PGF2 alpha, PGE1 tablet, PGE2 gel and misoprostol. So you can use all of these for induction of labor except PGF2 alpha, PGE1, PGE2, misoprostol. So just now I told you PGF2 alpha should never be used as a drug for the induction of labor. PGF2 alpha should never be used for induction of labor. It is carboprost. Where do you use carboprost actually? Carboprost is mainly used for PPH. It is the most potent drug for the treatment of PPH. The dose of carboprost is 250 micrograms IM or intramyometrial. Right? All of the following drugs are effective for cervical ripening during pregnancy except prostaglandin E2, oxytocin, progesterone, misoprostol. So yes, I told you the best drug for cervical ripening is prostaglandin E2. So prostaglandin E2 is definitely used for cervical ripening. Oxytocin, high dose oxytocin IV infusion can also be used for cervical ripening. But ideally oxytocin is mainly used for augmentation of labor. Progesterone can also be used for, progesterone helps in relaxation. So you should not have progesterone in order to have contractions. So progesterone is not used for cervical ripening. Misoprostol can also be used for cervical ripening. So here the answer is progesterone, because progesterone is not used for cervical ripening. Which of the following methods for induction of labor should not be used in a patient with previous lower segment cesarean section? Prostaglandin gel, prostaglandin tablet, stripping of membranes, and oxytocin drip. The drug which is absolute prostaglandin gel is nothing but dinoprostan, or the serviprine gel. So the prostaglandin gel is dinoprostan or the serviprine gel. This is useful. Prostaglandin tablet. Prostaglandin tablet is nothing but misoprostol. Misoprostol. Can you give misoprostol in lower segment cesarean section? Now a very important point. Misoprostol is an absolute contraindication in lower segment cesarean section. Misoprostol is an absolute contraindication in lower segment cesarean section. Stripping of membranes, yes, it is definitely useful. Stripping of membranes is definitely useful. So where you separate the amniotic membrane from the cervix, that will help in the release of prostaglandin. So it is a milder way. Actually, most of the time in lower segment cesarean section, ideal is to wait for spontaneous labor. If you are inducing in lower segment, better is to go with stripping of membranes, right? You can also start them on oxytocin drip. But misoprostol is an absolute contraindication where you should not use it in the lower segment cesarean section. So those were few questions which I thought I'll discuss about the Bishop's score. I know it's a small and short session. Basically, I want you to know what are the parameters of Bishop's score. So remember the parameters of Bishop's score as speed, S-C-P-E-D, speed. So that is station, consistency, position, effacement, and dilatation. In modified Bishop's score, effacement has been replaced by length of the cervix. Bishop's score of more than 8 is considered to be favorable, right? So thank you guys. I know it's a very late night class. So thank you. I'll be coming up with tomorrow some more sessions.